Welcome to Java Hangout channel. Today in this video we will discuss about how to convert object into JSON string and JSON string into object, vice versa. So in current market, 90% projects will use either SOA architecture or microservices architecture. SOA means service oriented architecture. In service oriented architecture, we use web services. There are two types of web services. One is SOAP, another one is REST. SOAP is difficult to implement because it represents the data only in XML format. Again, XML contains its own rules and regulations to learning and all. It is bit difficult. So REST, another option is REST. REST represents the data in several formats. One is JSON, HTML, text, XML as well. And implementation, learning, both are very easy. Okay, so this is the one. And the microservices. In microservices also, we use RESTful web services. However, RESTful web services, again, it represents data in several formats. Major one is JSON. JSON is a language. Language independent and platform independent. So this JSON format can be understood by any other language like React.js, Java, .NET, several things. So every developer must know how to convert the object into JSON, JSON into object, especially about JSON. Okay, let's jump into the practical, because I want to focus on more practical. Okay, in this scenario, so here this is the object, view object means value object, public class static implement serializable. So this is the one already I defined, which contains the four variables, instance variables. So one is name of the state, and what is the capital city of state, and number of districts in the state, and number of administrative divisions. You can take for demo anything, employee, student, these are the common. Just I tried with a different option, that is state. Okay, so after that we have to generate setter getter methods for this. We have shortcut for this one, alt shift s. It will give the pop-up. You can see generate setters and getters. Among them, you can choose whatever you want. Either here right hand side, select all, deselect all, select setters only, select only getter methods. Okay, I need all the setter and getter methods apart from serial version UID. So I'm selecting one by one all four. Just click on OK. It will automatically generates the setter getter methods. If you see get name and set name, for every attribute it will create generate setter getter methods. Apart from that, you can also generate what is this, to string method. So source, if you see same way, we don't need to write anything, generate to string. So in the toString method, whatever we want, we can select a name, a cap city, number of districts, number of administrative. If you want, you can methods, how many methods are there, those things will be added into the toString method. I want only attribute, that's why I selected 4. By default, it will fields will be selected. See how ready-made method is, public string toString. And what is the state value, capital city value, and number of districts, number of administrative divisions. Okay, this is the value object, and this object has to be converted into JSON string. So this object We do some operations, whatever we want, setter, getter methods, all available. That's why we represent in the object after doing all the modifications. Before sending, we will convert this one into the JSON string for that. If you see this one, I defined JSON utility. I defined it is as a utility class. Why? Because in generally big projects, this conversion, this requirement will be several places, not only one particular place. If you don't utilize this utility class, if you don't define as a utility, then we have to define all the places wherever it requires. That's why this is a decoupling. We can use define once and use several times. That is the option. So here I defined JSON utility. This is completely real-time implementation. Believe me, what we use generally, I'm defining this one. So it contains the two methods. One is public static string to string to JSON string. Okay. Why I used a public, all utility classes should have the static methods. Okay, so that's why. One more is public static to object. It will take two parameters. One is a JSON string, another one is a output class. So after converting that, which object has to be written? We have to pass that one also. Okay, it's taking two. Here it is taking only one, and it is returning object, and it returns a string. No need to pass that string as a input parameter. Okay, two. This is just a skeleton. Okay, now I already defined JSON string which needs to be returned, and here we use object mapper. So for object mapper, we need one dependency. So which is I already added here, that is Jackson mapper ASL. Whenever we add this one dependency into pom.xml automatically two jars will be added. If you see Maven dependencies, so after adding this one Jackson-mapper-ASL and Jackson-core-ASL will be added. If you have doubt, I will delete this one. See, save this one. See, those two things are gone, right? So those two jars are deleted, has been deleted. That's why we are getting here. So org this object mapper is not available. So we have to again add that one here. Just control Z. I added, I saved. Automatically those two jars will be added here. You see, those have been added JSON-mapper, JSON-core-ASL. Okay, so that's it. And so now actual business logic we have to implement here. We have the object, it has to be converted. So it will convert and return, it has to be written the string. So I already defined the string, JSON string equal to we are using object mapper control space. We have to use this one obj object mapper dot there are several methods to convert the object into string. There is a method called write value as a string, which takes input as object. Okay, that's it. Oh my god, it's again giving some blessings. See, what is that? So it's saying multiple markers at this line, unhandled exception type IO. So we have to, either we can do that one, we can throw, or else we can handle by using try catch. By using try catch, handling the exception is the good one. Okay, so just keep here control one, it will show suggestions. So you can use add throws declaration, or else surround with try catch or try with multiple catches. I'm using that one. done and so object mapper dot write as string which takes object and returns the string. That object will be converted and returns as a string. This implementation is done. And second method, vice versa, we have now JSON string that has to be converted into object. For that, here also I defined one more method, public static to object, which takes JSON string and object, which class, like that object string has to be converted into object, which type object we have to tell to that one, right? That's why we are passing that particular class dot class file. Okay, so I defined object mapper here again. I returned result equal to obj mapper, object mapper, control space dot read method is there, value, which takes two arguments. One is string, JSON string, another one is class. Here I is anything. Okay, so again it is giving some blessings. We see again we have to handle here also. So it is saying unhandled exception type JSON mapping exception. So best way is instead of throwing, we can handle that one within this method itself, surround with try multiple catches if multiple exceptions are there, done. So it is auto generated. We can delete that one by pressing Ctrl D. Here also by pressing Ctrl D, automatically that line will be deleted. Okay, so this read value method takes two arguments. One is a JSON string, another one is a class type of object, which object we are going to return. So that's it. So this is the actual business logic. We have two methods. One is converting object into the JSON string, another one is object JSON string into object. Two methods. Okay. Control S, save this one, and this is the test class. So first we have to define the object, right? I already defined a state as a value object, so which contains the four parameters and setter getter methods. I am just setting the values. State S is equal to new state, st dot set name, name is Karnataka. What is the state? Karnataka. And capital city of Karnataka is Bangalore. Number of districts in Karnataka 28. Number of administrative divisions are 4. That's why I mentioned 4 here. Okay, now object is ready. This object has to be converted into the JSON. Okay, so see this one. First I am printing system.out.println object, whatever object is there. And now I am calling it a two string method. So this two string method, whatever we defined in JSON utility, so it takes object and returns the string, which is JSON string. Okay, I am calling that one. Control shift slash. Okay, so this is the actual object. This is converted JSON string. We will see. We'll run. Right click, run as Java application. See this one, state first. This is the object state, name equal to Karnataka, capital city is Bangalore, number of districts is 28, number of administrative divisions are 4. This is the actual object. So whenever logic is there, we can get the values and do the logic and set back the values. So that's why we use object. And later while passing this values to the any rest service, so we will convert that object into the JSON. So that I passed here JSON like object to this to JSON string. This method will convert this object st object into JSON string, and it will return finally output as a JSON string. So this is the converted output. See JSON string from object, name, see different, this is the format here, double quotes, name, colon, and value. This is the key and colon value, key, colon, value, key, colon value. There they will use this key to get this value. They will use this key to get this value. This is while consuming like RESTful web services, service provider and service consumer will be there, right? They will. This is the representation of JSON. Okay. Now second requirement is I will comment out this one. We saw, right? I have seen output of this one. Now I will uncomment the logic for converting logic for converting JSON string into object reverse. Okay, now see this is already converted JSON string is there. Just I'm printing first that one, and after that I'm passing that JSON string and object class state dot class. So this method, two string method, two object method, just we have seen, right? We defined in JSON utility. You can press control, just click on that one, it will go to that particular implementation class. So two object which takes two arguments, right? And object mapper dot read value. Read value will take this JSON string and return the object. Okay, so so finally we will get the again back to object. Just run as Java application. See here JSON string, this is the actual JSON string. For example, now we are a consumer, so we will get this value from the service, RESTful web service. So once we get that one, we difficult to do operations on this one, right? We have to convert immediately that one into the object. So I am getting object from JSON string. This is the object. By using this object, we can do whatever we want the operations. This is how we will convert object into JSON string and vice versa, JSON string into object. Thank you for watching the video.